Okay everyone, so this is the second part of this portrait painting tutorial, and now I am going to focus on this part of the flowers. But if we're going to see how I did the portrait, so we can watch the first part, and I am going to also to put the materials that I use on this tutorial on the first part. Okay. So I have here the hibiscus flower or the gumamela flower. Okay, so first I'll be using this number 2 flat brush and red color or red paint. So I'm going to not to paint on the ridge on the stalk. So I'm gonna do this one first. So yeah, I am following my reference, but it will not always be perfect because I need to do it faster. I just want to make sure that my proportion is good. Okay. So I'll be using some raw umber and yellow. Need a little red. Because I'm gonna start to put some shadings. So this is the dark part of the yellow, okay? I'm gonna put some yellow. There. So I'll just put some tiny details, everyone. Using this yellow with a little darker yellows or shades like that. There. I'll do my best to create the best blendings here. So make sure that you don't put too much water. I want it to be dry, so. As you can see here, it's really hard to cover the pencil strokes. It's okay, I'll try to put the whites. So first I will need to use the pure white, just the pure white, everyone. Should be here. And here I'm gonna put a little white. So if you're asking me, I'm just following my reference, everyone. I'm gonna mix yellow and white to make it not so bright. So if you're asking me if my drawing is perfect from the reference, no, because if I'm gonna do that, it will take me lots of time. Also, if you just want to follow the Hibiscus tutorial and without a portrait, then you can also do that. This is also a good experience, just following this Hibiscus only tutorial. Yeah, if you're doing this one, everyone, I recommend that you need to erase the pencil sketch first before you can start, because in my case it's really hard to cover it because it's, yellows and whites are really thin colors, so I might need to create more coats on this for this one. I'm gonna put the stock later for the pollen grains or something. I just put some little tiny details here. Yeah, I think I can see now its beauty. So here I'm gonna put more with a little red to make it a little orange, and I want it to be thick. So I'll just copy the patterns, but it's gonna be as perfect as you see in the picture, because I want to finish it as early as possible, everyone. So I'm gonna do my best just to make it realistic. Those lines are still visible, but maybe later I'm going to retouch that. Yeah, so far it looks good. And I'm gonna use this red and a little yellow and white. I'll just try to blend this part here. Thank you. Let's try to blend this part. Okay. And then I'm gonna use a darker colors. So I'll be using this raw umber and red. Just to make this part darker. Okay. Now I'll try to retouch the background. So here I have the raw umber and the blue to make it dark. Okay, then I'm gonna put some background colors on the flower, so it will be some more like greens, so it's blue and yellow again. You can create variety of greens, everyone. Okay. And put also a little red. Make this color a little reddish. I'll do my best to copy from my reference, but it should always have a difference. Okay, so we're going to use a little brush, which is the number 3 flat brush, 2. So I'll just be a little careful to follow some of the curves of this plant, or this petals. It will be a little tricky. Just make sure everyone that I have a very clean edges here, but we need to blend the edges here, but I'll just do it later on. Okay. I don't know about hibiscus. So I will put the pull in. I will be using the smaller brush, number one liner brush or round brush. So here I have some red, I'll mix it to yellow to make it orange. And I will try to blend a little here, a little shades. Okay, there. Then of course I will start to put some pollens. Still wet. Those pollens, everyone, pollen grains are just like look like random dots. There. It's just a yellow. Now I'm gonna use the white. I'll try to clean this one here. Okay, so I zoom out so that we can see the entire view, and now I'm going to start putting the entire details. I'm done with the flowers, and I will now proceed to retouching of everything and putting the background. So of course I will put the background first, and I think I'm gonna do it the hair. So I have here the umber. Just use umber and blue to make it look like black. Thank you. Okay. Blue will make the color darker. And I'm gonna start putting some darker shades. Okay, before that, I'm going to put some more reds. Because I want to see solid reds. Just try to fill entirely with these colors. Because acrylic, everyone, is really hard to blend, so make sure that everything looks solid before I'm going to add details. So I'll just try to make everything plain red, everyone, a flat red. There. And now I'm going to fill the background. Yeah. With the dark greens. So first I'm going to use the blue and the yellow. can also try to blend the edge. Also put the raw umber here. I'm gonna make this part a little dark. Gonna need some blue. Make this background as smooth as possible. You can actually use the bigger brush, the number 12 liner brush, but I like this brush for this one because I can do it little by little. There I have now some beautiful backgrounds. I'm gonna put a little umber. I'll try to blend the edge, it should be smooth. Okay, so I have now some backgrounds, and also on the other side I need to put the backgrounds also. I'm gonna make this part a little darker on this bottom side, and I'm going to blend perfectly the edges. Okay, and also here. And then I'm gonna try to blend more on this part. Okay. And then I will start putting the branches and leaves for the plant. So first I'm gonna use this raw umber. I'll just use the plain raw umber, and I will have to make this line here straight. So I think this part is a little wet, so I need to let it dry first. And I think I'm gonna start adding details on the on the hair first. So. So we have here the umber and the blue. Then I'm gonna put some white. There. Make it a little darker. And some blue. So you can just create some random lines like this. But you need to create randomly, because later I'm gonna put tinier details. But first we need to I'm gonna add more blue. Later, everyone, I'm gonna put tinier details. Don't worry about it. Okay. Now we'll start to put tinier details, tinier fraction, or tinier. The nearest strand of hairs, but I will use the liner brush, which is this one. Here. So, what I like this one is again I can put tinier details and smaller. Okay. So you make sure that it's wet so that you can drag it easily on your canvas. There. Let me get a little lighter. I'll try to make it a little darker. Just try to adjust the tone, everyone. Okay, then we're gonna put some darker tones covering some light part. Okay, so raw umber and blue again. Just try to blend the lighter colors. There. And also here, I need to blend. Okay, and I will start putting the details of the edge of the coat. I'll do my best to make this blend. So I'm gonna use some red and arrow umber. I'll try to add some more. Darker tones here on the coat. And in here. Okay. Yeah, I think this one is dry. Still a little wet, so I'm continue adding details on the coat. I use some red and white. I'll just put on the edge here. And in here. There. But I will make the other part dark just to create drama in this painting. Also the edge should be smooth like that. Okay. And then also here, I need to put some I'm gonna make it a little lighter. Sorry everyone, my our neighbor's dog is a little noisy. Yeah. Gonna put a little details here. Then I'll try to blend. Yeah, I will not make it too light. Okay. Try to put some tinier details, some darker tones, some lines. Okay, using this romber. Okay, I can see now that I'm almost done, but I need to do more on the, I still need to put some details on the flowers, so I need to put something here, some branches and also the leaves. Okay, so I have here some light light green, so I just put white to the existing green here and yellow and blue. Have something here. There. And then also here. Thank you. in the flower's stem. There. Yeah, I have not the idea where I put the colors of the stem of the leaves. Okay, so blue and yellow, yep, here. Okay, I was trying to put, I'm gonna start to put some colors. So everyone, I'll bring up the tones. Also here. Okay, and now I'll put darker. So here the amber, the blue, and the yellow. Okay. For this part, everyone at the bottom, it should be dark. I want it to remain dark. Yeah. And then I will try to start to put some highlights. So here I have some white and mix it to the yellow green, it will be more light green. So we can put a little contour on the or zigzag on the top of the leaf. Yeah. And just here I'm going to put a little smaller. And then I'll try to put some white and blue. There. That was it. Outside white. Yeah, you cannot see clearly the leaves there, but I want it to remain dark. Because I want to make it look more dramatic. Okay, so I think I'm gonna put some leaves here, cutting this part. I'm gonna add more blue and yellow, and a little white. So I'll try to put it here. So I'm gonna put some leaves here, but first I'm gonna put some green as the background colors. There. And then some tiny leaves. Thank you. Yeah. There. Okay. And on the background, I'm gonna put some disappearing lips there. We need to be very, very light, a dark. I mean, there, okay. So I'll try to retouch. I'm gonna put some white here. There. And then some dark blue, yellow and some amber. Yeah, but still wet. It's hard to cover some colors. Maybe later, everyone. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, but this part, I want it to be dark. I want to disappear that part. So I'll use some amber and red. I want this part to be really, really dark. And and on the neck, it should be dark. Yeah, I think I'm almost done, everyone. So the last part will be retouching the entire face. I'll just try to retouch a little, then maybe I'll do more offline, some of it. Yeah, because so far it really looks good in the camera, so I really like it and I love the result. It looks really well. I'll try to retouch. I'm now in the stage of retouching, everyone, so this is the final stage. Oh wait, I'm going to put some darker amber here. Okay, so I'm going to throw umber and red and yellow. And before that, I need to spray it with water. Okay, so it's very important, everyone, so that I can blend it perfectly. Good. So yeah, I'm gonna retouch. I don't put it too much, it will actually flow. Yeah, that's a problem. So here I'm gonna put more. So I'll just leave it alone for a while, because I'm gonna retouch here. Red under umber. Okay. It flows here. I'm gonna put some dark tones here. Some lighter flesh tone, I mean darker, so yellow, red, and I think the umber. What I like about adding covering the wet paints that I can blend it good. I like this one. But the face is not perfectly good, everyone. I really need to retouch more on that. But I think I'm gonna do it offline, because maybe retouching I need more time retouching than painting the entire. Okay. Okay, so raw umber and black. Okay, so I think I'm gonna try to retouch on this part. So this part should be a little pointed. because on retouching everyone, I need to subtract and add some things, so it's very important. And on this part also. I think I need to put a little hair. Yeah, but first I need to cut this one. I'm gonna mix for lighter skin tone. I'm gonna put it here. It's still dark. I'm gonna put white. And I need to blend that part of the forehead. First, I need to spray. And I need more white. What I like about the water spray that I can wet the canvas and I can create a good blends. I'm going to put a lighter color here on the between the nose. There. Make it a little darker and blend it here. There. I need to make sure that this part has a good lens. Okay, so yeah, I think I still need more retouch, everyone. But so far it looks really good. It just look realistic, but there's still more to do for this one. This part of the lips I'm going to touch there. I need to make this part a little lighter. So now everyone, I am now in the process of retouching. I need to retouch most of the parts because something lacking. It's probably this one. Okay. Okay. Okay, so we did my final retouch, everyone. So I'm gonna put a little hair here, but on the screen. But maybe I need to put more. Yeah, here. I think I'm gonna make it lighter on this part. The hood. So I'll just put some small hair. On the forehead. So I'll be using the raw umber and mix it with the lighter brown so that it won't be so dark. Also here. Okay, and I'm gonna use darker color. I'll just try to use this amber with blue. And then final will be on the hood. I'm gonna make it a little lighter on the top part so that it will glow on this part. I'm gonna add some white. I'm gonna need to blend. Adding some darker color. A darker pink or something. So I'm going to blend the edge. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so I want to retouch more of them, especially the lips. Yeah. I want to put details on it. I'll be using a smaller brush. I'll use first the red with white, so it will be a little pinkish. it should be not so dark. I'm gonna put a little light there. There. And I'm gonna mix for a little orange, yellow. Should be a little flesh color, man. I'm now on the process of retouching on the lips. I try to put lighter. A little brownish, darker brown, so I'm gonna make this part a little darker. I'll extend. I need to keep on retouching everyone to see which parts we need to fix. And I think here I need to fix something here. Okay. Yeah, I'll try to retouch more, like the eyebrows. So here. I'll make a little eyebrow fat. By adding a little strand of hair. Okay, so I think the last part, everyone, so in this video, so I'll just retouch this one and then, but I'll still keep on retouching on anything that will make this painting more similar to my reference. So I'll just keep on, I'll just try to retouch this the last part here. Blue and yellow. I just want to make this part dark. Also here, I just try to retouch. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna use some white. Make it look like glowing. There. Okay. Okay, everyone, so I think for now I am content with this one, and I will add more retouch. I will fix everything what I see, make it less, or I'm going to try to make it more beautiful. So I will retouch some of it offline. So for now, for the tutorial, I think this will be good, and I hope you can get out of this and you can paint your own portrait. So yeah, I just need more retouch for the face, so I'll keep retouching that part. Okay, everyone, so I wanna say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this.
And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.